Good evening. This is Gab with Gab, and I got my co-host Richard Carrington here. And you guys already know what's going on with your boy Bill Cosby.
Yes, yeah.
You know, and I guess it's a happy day for him, huh?
Yeah, man, very happy day, you know. Yesterday seemed, you know, when we got the news, it was surprising. I know I was surprised. I know a lot of people were surprised, but he walked out of there, man.
Yeah, yeah, and, yeah. You know, and we're here to talk about how he did it.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. First, they said they kept him back because he wasn't doing some things what he's supposed to have been doing, and now come find out he got out on a technicality, right?
Right. So basically, man, I don't know if this has ever happened to you, man, but where you sat down with someone and you made an agreement, mm-hmm. and then they said, okay, well, if you do X, Y, and Z, mm-hmm. then, you know, I'll do, you know, A, B, C.
Right.
Or if you take care of this, you know, then I'll take care of this. Mm-hmm. And they didn't hold up their end of the bargain.
Yep.
You know what I mean?
That was true.
So basically what happened was he testified mm-hmm. For the grand jury. And they said, you know, if you... are honest with us and you tell us what's going on and you give us information, we won't prosecute you.
Right.
Then they went ahead and prosecuted him.
Yeah, yeah. And so he shouldn't have had no jail time anyway.
None whatsoever.
So they gave him jail time, which was like, what, 2 years, right?
Yeah. Well, he was going to get between, I think it's 3 and 10 years.
Yeah.
But, you know, so he was serving that.
Right.
You know, and he served two.
Yep. And then the technicality popped up or whatever.
Yeah. So he went to the Supreme Court. His lawyers, you know, his team. His legal team is tough, man.
Yeah, because, I know.
You know, man, and, I mean, it's a touchy situation because we're not ones to say we totally are not in favor of anything happening to women inappropriately.
Right. Exactly.
So we're going to be clear about that.
Yes.
We don't believe in anything that has to do with hurting women in any type of way.
No doubt.
And there's not even a but we're going to say, as far as what happened to him, mm-hmm. he was railroaded. And
right.
he, you know, he was.
Yep.
And two things can happen at the same time. You can be wrong on one level, but that doesn't mean you get, you know, you're wrong on all these other levels. You know what
I'm
saying?
Right, I get what you're saying.
So, it's kind of a trip, man, because, you know, you bring a guy in there, he's an older guy, mm-hmm. who was he, 79, 80, you bring him in there, and you say, look, if you do this, you know, we got you. And mm-hmm. then you just flip on him.
Mm-hmm. Now, that just was weird to me. I didn't understand it. Now, you know, how many, it was all kind of ladies that came forward after saying he drugged them and stuff like that.
Right.
Now, that may be true, or he admitted to that, right?
Right.
But then, like you said, but the grand jury was wanting him to do, like, a deal. Kind of like a deal.
Yeah, basically, they said, you know, because it was a civil case, they said, if you cooperate, mm-hmm, we won't, you know, charge you for anything you share.
Right.
So he said, you know, I gave the girl, because it was the woman from Temple.
Right, the coach or something, right?
That is really behind all this. But there's been, you know, other women, and there's been a history known to him that, but some of that stuff they did in Hollywood, you know, they took those drugs, Quaaludes and Spanish flies and all that stuff. You know what I mean? To have crazy sex and stuff, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah, that was like
some of it. Yeah, so some of it was, you know, partying. However, again, if a woman says that, you know, I didn't consent to it or he drugged me,
right,
you know, we'll say, okay.
No means no.
Exactly.
I'm guessing.
Yeah.
What they say, what they're trying to say anyway.
You know, but just think about this, man. If you went into a place and you said, you know, okay, Larry, now all you have to do is just tell us what happened, and then that'll be it. And then you tell them what happened, and then they come back and throw the cuffs on you.
Yeah, that's crazy.
You know?
That ain't right. That's not a bargain.
Right.
That wasn't the deal.
Right, right.
You know? But, it's crazy, man. But he did his time. Regardless how it happened, he was railroaded. Like you said, he was railroaded.
Yeah.
You know, but, you know, when I look at the whole situation, man, Bill Cosby was like the favorite dad.
Yeah.
You know, everybody's favorite dad.
Yeah,
you know,
he was.
Family guy. Clean cut from what we see and what we knew.
Right.
But everybody got skeletons.
Everybody
man.
Got
skeletons.
And
I'm not here to bash him.
Right.
But we have to do the other side of it, too.
Right.
You know, and I just don't understand why was he doing that type of stuff. Didn't they say he was diagnosed with something?
Oh, no, I didn't hear that part.
I thought that what he was doing, the drugging and stuff like that, some type of sickness.
Oh.
Some type of, I forget what they called it. Said,
some type of like sexual sickness
or something like that. Right, right,
right. Yeah, some type of perversion maybe.
Exactly, exactly.
I don't know about that, man. But I do know, like you said, there's two sides to, and no one's perfect.
Right.
And, you know, there's two sides to every story. There's really three sides. But but when you look at, like you said, which is important, man.
Yep.
That he was one of the only positive black males that was on TV for many years.
Yes, yes.
And a lot of young males ascribe to be like the character he played.
Right.
Not so much
you.
Him.
I get you.
But they ascribe to be like, because I was talking to a young brother the other day, and he said, you know, I didn't have a lot of male role models in my family, but, you know, I looked at the Cosbys. I wanted to create a life like they had on TV.
Emily.
Yeah. So, you know, so that, you know, I give him credit for that.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and you know, every, you know, now if he, you, we still don't know everything.
Right? Exactly, exactly.
And, you know, stories change, and, you know, now Alicia Rashad, you know, they're attacking her because she, you know, basically said, you know, she was glad that he was treated fairly.
Right.
She didn't say anything about she, you know,
right
she was
wrong.
Glad he
right
got away
wrong.
With, yeah. if he got away with raping someone or right. drugging some woman, if he got away with it. She just said she was glad that he was treated fairly. And that's the thing that we got to kind of understand that, like, everything is not always just so black and white.
Right,
so,
right.
You know, because we can get, you know, and black males have a history of being railroaded.
Exactly.
Being, you know, being tricked in the court system, being serving time when they shouldn't have.
You're right.
You know what
and
I'm saying?
And that's happening to this day.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. So look at him. He's a multimillionaire.
Yeah.
And they did that to him. And he had to fight because he had the money.
Yes. Number one.
He had that money to get the best lawyers
to fight for him.
And go all the way to the
Supreme Court.
Yeah.
How many people can do that?
Pennsylvania.
How many people can do that? You know?
So, you know, so I think people are happy that he beat the crooked system.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
Not that he got away with anything. But that he fought and beat a crooked system.
Exactly. You know? And you're right. The system is crooked.
Yeah.
Because if they said, okay, we're going to do this for you and vice versa, and we're going to get, you know, jail time, they reneged on that on that deal.
Yeah.
So by law, by retrospect, they were wrong.
He
got treated wrong by them.
Yes, he did.
So I'm not going to say regardless of what really happened.
Right.
But they had a part of the wrongdoing.
Right, right. So if you convict them fairly, then hey, he's there, man. Let him sit there.
Right.
If that's what it is. But if it's not fair and you lie.
Yeah, that's no good.
You know what I mean?
That's no good either.
That's crazy, man. Because, you know, I guess it's going to bring up a lot of feelings with a lot of people, and then some women are going to feel like, you know, he got away with something.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think he got away with anything, man, because he still did 2 years
in
jail.
Right.
But if he wasn't treated fairly, then
he still has
a right in the court of law. Like all of us.
Yeah.
We can go, you know, we can go outside tomorrow and end up killing somebody, but we still got a right to a fair trial.
Right, right. That's the way
it is. And then you
say,
okay, fair trial. I was wrong. Now take me to jail.
Exactly.
But if you just railroad me.
Yeah. That ain't no good. That's not a fair trial.
No.
People are innocent until proven guilty.
Exactly.
And this country.
Right.
You know what I mean? So
exactly.
And that's what they're supposed to do.
Exactly.
He did, and then come to find out now he was railroaded. So he got time served, which he shouldn't have got nothing.
Right.
But he got it, and he's out, and hopefully he's 80 years old, man.
Yeah.
So hopefully he learned his lesson some kind of way.
I think he learned. I think he sat in there for 2 years and said, oh, man.
Yeah.
And you know what? He never changed his story either.
Nope.
They wanted him to change his story. He said, nope, I'm standing by this story. This is what it is.
Yeah, yeah.
You know?
And a lot of what probably happened was a party situation, this, that, and the other. So who knows?
Right.
Who knows what he was doing, or was he really drugging him like that, or... We wasn't there, bro.
Yeah. My brother, he used to live out in L.A. He lived with a guy that was a famous movie star.
Mm-hmm.
And he used to tell me that he used to have wild parties. Those parties would be so wild that he ended up leaving L.A. and moving to San Diego because
he couldn't deal with all
the stuff he saw. You know what I mean?
Jeez.
He didn't want it to corrupt him. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But let me ask you a question, brother. Mm-hmm. If you had a chance to interview Bill Cosby, what would you say to him? What would you say?
You know what, man? I would be just like I always am. I'm gonna be my gab with gab self.
Straightforward.
And I'm gonna ask him. I'm gonna be straightforward with him. You know, because whether he wanna tell me or not,
right.
I'll ask him. And I'll ask him about I'll go all the way back.
Yeah.
Okay, you know, back in the 70s and stuff like that, was it a good time? Did you guys had a good time doing drugs and stuff like that?
Right.
Then I'll ask him, was stuff like that the norm?
Right. Because he admitted to giving the girl
yeah.
the Quaaludes.
Yeah.
So he gave her the drugs.
Right. Well, then I'll ask him, you know, is that something that you wanted to do, or is something that you would a play drug,
right?
Or
right.
Were you doing stuff just to test them?
Right.
You know, what was the reason for you doing that? Because I'm gonna tell you something about me. The way I look at that as far as a man drugging a woman,
yeah.
that's just like that's unfair.
It is unfair,
you know,
man.
You ask me, he ain't got no rap game.
Right.
You know,
right.
You can't talk to this individual. This woman can get her to sleep with you or whatever you want to do.
Right.
Then don't do that.
Right. If you got to resort to that.
That's the way I was raised.
Right. Right.
You know,
no,
I was raised
right.
that way.
No, I hear you. 100%.
Yeah, you got to resort to drugging. Then that's the wrong game.
Right.
You know, but I would ask him that. I would ask him all of that. I mean, I would try not to make them feel uncomfortable, but I wouldn't get down to the real thing because, hey, I'm a journalist. Just like I'm a journalist,
right.
I'm trying to find out. You know, I want to get a good story.
Exactly.
And whether he want to say it or not, I don't know. But I definitely will ask him.
Right.
I definitely will ask him. You know, and as far as getting too personal, you know, maybe I might straddle that line a little bit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I got to get a good story, right?
I think you would do a great job interviewing him.
Yeah.
What, you know, you remember. There was a time where he was coming on TV a lot just
mm-hmm.
before all this happened, and he was telling, you know, brothers, pull up your pants and all that stuff.
Yep.
You remember when he was really like, you know,
yep.
black man got to stand up and
oh,
be a
yeah.
man and all that.
Oh, yeah.
And then
he was talking about, he had got on Eddie Murphy about cursing and stuff
yeah,
like
right,
that.
Right, right, right.
And then he turned around and then this.
And then this happened.
So is he hypocritical?
Right.
You know?
Right.
My thing is this, you know, if you live in a glass house, don't throw no stone.
That's what they say, bro.
You know, and I'm not judging him.
Right.
But still, I look at people like that. If you giving me advice,
right.
don't do the do as I say, not as I do type thing.
Exactly.
Be true to the game.
Exactly.
You know, and maybe I might listen to you, but your value drops whenever you're trying to give some good advice and you up here preaching the gospel, whatever you're doing, and then you turn around and do something else.
Right.
Your value drops.
It does.
And I hate to say it. You know, so now, because everybody want to be able to believe in somebody or trust somebody or listen and take heed to what somebody else is saying based on where they've been and their knowledge and stuff like that. But then you turn around and say, oh, this man, he just BSing.
Right.
Now you're like, forget this guy.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Right. Yeah, man. It's tough because, you know, you want to be fair with everybody. You know, you want to give them the benefit of the doubt, but you want to be real. And you want to just say, hey, man, like you said, I could see you interviewing him, man.
I would love this. Man.
I know, man.
I would love to get it done, man.
So
love to.
So it's out there if he wants it. You know?
Tell him, Bill. Come to me, Gab with Yab, and I'm ready to sit you down.
Treat you fair.
Exactly, exactly. And another thing I heard, I'm going into what I heard now.
Yeah.
I saw an interview with John Amos, the guy that played mm-hmm. James on Good mm-hmm. Times, and they asked him about Bill Cosby.
Yeah.
And he said he was on a Cosby show once or twice, and he said Cosby didn't allow no cursing on the show.
Yeah.
And so he said a little something. Everybody stopped. And said, did I do something wrong?
Yeah.
And he said, and then Fleece Rashad had to come to him and say, yeah, John, he don't like no cursing on the set.
Oh, okay.
So it's whatever. He said, okay, whatever. But then he said basically that it was evident that to see what was going on around there.
Oh.
He might not have actually seen him do something crooked, do something crazy,
right.
But he probably be like, yeah, Bill doing something like
right
around
doing
here.
Something, yeah.
You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. But a lot of people may turn a blind eye to that because they getting paid.
Yes, man.
And he get a lot of people jobs, don't get
me
wrong.
Right.
But you have to look at, your integrity. Me, I got to have my integrity.
Yeah.
I got to be able to sleep at night.
Exactly.
You know, just because you're paying me money, I ain't going to turn my head to some BS that you're doing.
Right.
You know,
yeah, especially you hurting someone.
Right,
you know?
I can't get out like that.
No,
you know,
money worth that because, like you said, you can't look at yourself in the mirror. You can't sleep at night. No,
look at your kids and things like that.
Yeah.
Knowing, you know, no knowing that, you know this guy did that. And then now, if it leak out, oh, you was working with him. Did you see that?
Right.
So well, now I got to be exactly. tap dancing and stuff. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I didn't really see it, but I think it was going on, blah, 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 blah.
Right.
You know, but hey, you know, it is what it is.
It is, man.
You Everybody know. Has skeletons in their closet. Ain't nobody squeaky clean.
No, that's right. And I'm just really glad, man, that, you know, that the court system, you know, fixed and rectified the, you know, the miscarriage of justice.
Yes, yes. Know? And another thing, another story I'm getting into, you remember that story was going around and he was trying to buy NBC?
Yes.
And he got jammed up behind that.
Yeah, that's what they were saying.
You think
there
was any truth in that, man?
I don't know, man. I think that there could be something to it, man. Mm-hmm, because, you know, they only want us to have so much power, you know?
Of course.
And him running a whole
network would a lot of power.
Yeah.
A lot of power.
Yeah.
You know, and
you know, in Hollywood, they got secrets. They all got secrets.
Of
they
course.
Got secrets on them, and they use them if you go too far.
Yep.
You know.
Yep. And they just
might have
been.
You
they've been like, okay. Well, I'm gonna drop this dime here.
Yep.
Because you going a little too far, and you almost there. So I got the only way I'm gonna stop you is to do this.
Yep.
And all they gotta do is just put some in the water.
Boop. That's it, man.
And there it is.
It's
just sad.
It's a vicious world.
Man. It is, man. It's a dog eat dog world.
Yes, it is.
And once again, we still can't get ahead.
Yeah.
Because of something that you know, we try to get ahead, they knock us back two steps.
Yep. So we just gotta keep fighting, bro.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
And we gotta stay clean.
Yes.
You know,
we do.
Because the other man can do what he wanna do, but we can't have no strikes.
Nope.
None.
Nope.
Cause you know they waiting to knock us down.
So, seriously, bro.
You know. But I'm glad he's out and you know, he's back with his family. And another thing, you know, what do you think about his wife? What does she think about the whole situation? They never interviewed her.
Right.
Maybe they didn't want her to feel uncomfortable. But she got to feel some type of way.
She has to, man. You know, she has to. You know, and then, you know, she stood by him.
Yeah,
you know,
of course.
So, you know, this, who knows, man.
Yeah. Like you said, that Hollywood crap, man.
Yeah, man.
Maybe it'll come on, maybe it won't.
Because you got a good life. You're living a good life. You don't want to mess it up.
Yeah. And you know she's living a good life.
Yeah, man.
You know, so she probably figured, you know, if he like that, he like that. If he dirty, well, I'm going to stay right here and keep on keeping on until it affect me.
Right.
I guess, because most of this stuff is on him.
Yeah.
Basically.
Right.
You know. And he had kids too, right?
Yeah.
How many kids he had?
One of his, I think he has two. One was murdered.
Yeah,
the son.
On the street, right?
Yeah. Ennis, I think his name was.
Ennis.
He was murdered. I think he has a daughter as well.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, man, but hey, like I said, good luck to you, Bill, and I hope you bounce back.
I just hope you get a little peace.
Lay low and relax. You at that age now, you need to just count your blessings and just, you know, take care of your kids and your family and your grandkids, you know?
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Got anything else to say about that?
No, man, just that, you know, Bill, you know, you got an open invitation. So
yeah, I want you on the show, Bill. I want to talk to you. I want to know the truth from your mouth.
That's right. Yes.
Once again, we're going to wrap this up, you guys. This is Gab with Gab and my buddy Richard Carrington, and we out.
Thank you.